Good morning, 10th. This is nervous system. I am beginning today. See, every organism must somehow become aware of what is going on around it and accordingly perform actions for its survival. Apart from actions which provide adjustment to the external environment, there are so many activities which are going inside our body which we are unaware. So all these actions have to be properly timed and coordinated, and this occurs through two agencies: nervous system and hormonal system. Nervous system is dealt here, while hormonal system would be done in separate chapter. So need of nervous system in our body, it performs following major functions. First one, that it keeps us informed about outside world through the sense organs. So sense organs are an important part of nervous system. They act as window for the brain, enables us to remember, to think and to reason out. That is done by brain. Controls and harmonizes all voluntary muscular activities, running or even holding this book. Then regulates involuntary actions such as breathing or beating of heart without our thinking about them. Neuron, this is the unit for nervous system, and don't get confused by neuron with nephron. Some of the children are writing. Nephron is the filtering unit present in kidney. In previous chapter we have done, this is neuron that you all know. Nervous system consists of brain, spinal cord, sensor receptors and a whole lot of nerves. And brain and spinal cord are made up of neuron or nerve cells. So what is structure of neuron? Diagram is given on next page. It is having cell body, three main parts, that is cell body, dendrites and axon. Cell body also called as perikaryon or cyton. This is the part which is surrounding nucleus, contain nucleus in the center. It contains well-defined nucleus surrounded by granular cytoplasm. So whole part is called as cell body. Then it has all the cell organelles like the other cells. Only centrosome is absent because nerve cells have lost the ability to divide. This is give reason question, please mark it. That centrosome, why centrosome is absent in brain? Because nerve cells, how many we have at the time of birth? Only that many we have throughout the life. Then dendrites, these are branched cytoplasmic projections of the cell body, and they conduct nerve impulses to the cyton. So this was the second part. Then we move to axon. That is the long process from the cell body, and it varies in size from few millimeters to even more than 1 meter in length. In most neurons, axon is surrounded by a white insulating sheath that is known as myelin sheath, which is covered by an outermost thin membrane, that is neurilemma. Spelling you have to learn correctly. Myelin sheath shows gap throughout the length, and those are called as nodes of Ranvier. Some axons. So axons may have side branches which are called as collaterals. Myelin sheath having gap is node of Ranvier. That diagram I'll explain. Then end portion of the axon have swollen end like those are called as bulbs, which store certain chemicals which we call neurotransmitter, and its name you have to learn, that is acetylcholine. It will come later. Axon terminals are closely placed near dendrites of another one or more neurons but are not connected. Closely placed, but still gap is there. Such gaps in between, they are called as synaptic cleft. Here you can see the diagram of nerve cell or neuron. Generalized structure they have given. These are the dendrites. Dendron finally divided into dendrites. This is all cyton. In the center, it has nucleus, cyton or perikaryon or cell body. Axon is the long process. ठीक है? With neurilemma, the outermost sheath, myelin sheath, they have not given it distinctly. Okay, but you know, the neurilemma is the outermost, the central one is myelin sheath. Node of Ranvier, the in between, it is having gaps. Myelin sheath is having gap in between. Those are called as node of Ranvier. Correct spelling you have to learn. Some granules also present inside the cytoplasm of cell body or cyton. That is called as Nissl granules. Nucleus, prominent nucleus. And which cell structure they are not having? They are not having centrosome because no division is required. Then extra cell covering the axon, that is nerve fiber. And terminal axons. Okay. Nerve endings are there, axon endings, and these are the terminals which have neurotransmitter. Okay, now some basic terms in nervous activity. stimulus, an agent or sudden change of. These are four definitions you need to learn. Agent or a sudden change of the external or internal environment that results in a change in an organism or its any of the body part. Like if you see the teacher, you enter in the class fastly as you were outside the class. Or if you are feeling hungry, then you feel like, so that is stimulus. Response, the change in an organism. So entering in the class is response by stimulus. Impulse is a wave of irritability, that is electrical disturbance that sweeps over the nerve cell. Receptors, the specialized epithelial cells, which on receiving the stimulus set a wave of impulses towards central nervous system. And effectors are the muscles or glands, which on receiving impulse from the brain contract or secrete substances. So these all you need to learn for definition. Then transmission of nerve impulse. In the normal condition, the outer side of nerve fiber carries positive charge. This is called polarized state. This polarization is due to more sodium ions outside the axon membrane. They have given the diagram here. Okay. And sodium ions outer side. When excited state, reverse happens. Okay, what happens on a stimulation, that is mechanical, electrical, chemical or heat, etc., the axon membrane at that spot becomes more permeable to sodium ions, which move inward and cause loss of polarization. So this is polarized state, resting region. Excited state is having sodium permeability increases of this membrane and sodium ion enters inside, and this is excited region. The point of depolarization, this point now becomes a stimulus for the next area, for the next neighboring area of membrane, which in turn becomes depolarized. And slowly this wave continues, that you can see. So this is acting as a stimulus. So here now the sodium ions will enter inside, membrane permeability will increase and sodium ion enter inside, and continuously this wave sweeps along the axon or nerve. Meanwhile, the previous area becomes repolarized due to active transport of sodium ions. Again, active is using energy. Outside, they move by using energy, and this transport is achieved by what is called sodium pump, using energy through ATP. So this is how transmission of nerve impulse takes place. That's all for this video. Thank you.